Hi, I'm JR Heckler, Product Manager for DX1, and I'm very excited to introduce you to our latest feature release. Over the last few months, we've been working hard to improve system performance and stability. In this first release of the new year, we're adding new features you've been asking for, a few new tweaks to help you work faster, and a large number of bug fixes and under-the-hood enhancements. So let's take a look at some of the changes we'll be rolling out to you over the next few weeks. First off, we've added a new feature called Easy Pay. Easy Pay is a way for you to view your DX1 invoices, make payments, and also enroll in auto pay. Simply click the Easy Pay icon, register in the interface, and you'll be on your way. Another feature we're adding is a quick navigation search. You select the compass icon at the top of the screen, start typing, and we'll show you areas that are relevant to your search. We've also made a lot of really exciting changes to search. In parts invoicing, for example, today you can search by customer or invoice number. But now we've added new features, for example, part description, part number, and salesperson. We've also added a department dropdown to allow you to search invoices by department. We've added these same search fields in service and parts. One thing that's really interesting that we've added in service is the ability to search by VIN. So today it can be very hard to find an invoice for a vehicle if it's not the first vehicle on the invoice. With a VIN search, you can search for a model that is not the first in the invoice. We'll show it in the list. And when you click in the detail, you'll see that there are other vehicles on this invoice. In major unit sales, we have the same search fields, and we've also added a type dropdown to allow you to find quotes and deals easier. We've also overhauled the way that lists display in this release. So you'll be able in this release to click and drag columns. If you don't like the way information is displayed, you can simply reorder it. You can also sort on any field. And these changes will stay in place even after you leave this screen, even after you log out. So the screen will always appear in the way you want it. In parts ordering, we've made some changes to make the screen a little easier. For example, in the part number field, we're going to show a little gray box. This makes it easier to understand that that field is editable. Once you've added your part and click into it, you can use the tab button to move through the line, but we're only going to highlight fields that you can edit. This just makes the interface a little easier to understand. Another change we're making in this release is the ability to send emails from invoicing. When you select the email icon and the documents you'd like to send, you'll see a pop-up for the email. You'll be able to select a custom template, who the email should be replied to when the customer receives it, the sender's name, where the email is going. You can even carbon copy or blind carbon copy. You can edit the subject, and you can also, right in this window, totally customize this email. These email templates can be altered in dealership settings. In the email templates area, we'll list out all of the templates. The default templates that are sent for certain actions will be in bold, but you can always add your own. You can also make new templates and assign them to be defaults for different areas. We're also making a really big change we're very excited about for models and freight and setup fees. Today you can set freight and setup at the manufacturer or the type level. This can often be frustrating when you are checking out and doing an invoice. You have to redo freight and setup on individual models. It's time consuming and a real irritation. In this release, we're going to allow you to set freight and setup charges on individual models. When you save that freight and setup, we'll also ask you if you want to apply that to all of your current inventory. So if you select yes, these charges will apply to all of this particular model you have in inventory. You can also select no. Regardless of what you select, this freight and setup cost will be applied to any unit you receive after you've entered these values. You can always come back and change them later if you need to. We've also made some changes to our major unit reporting. We've updated our reporting system to be faster, to be better performance, especially when you're running large reports. One feature we're adding into the reports is the ability to sort columns. You'll see the indicators here. Now, the sorting of columns requires adjustment of each report in the system, so you may not see that feature right away. But rest assured, we'll be rolling that out very soon. So these features make up a portion of this release. You're going to be receiving a notification on the DX1 dashboard that will direct you to the full release notes, and keep an eye on your email inbox for a summary of these features. Thanks for watching. You can always check out our help section or contact our support team for questions, comments, and certainly provide feedback on these features and anything else you'd like to see in future releases.